The way I look at it is, if I'm just going to put an ad in the back of paper of the paper, and it's going to be like, "Do you want your band to get back together? Get Myles to sing with you."
Planet Rock. It's my Planet Rocks on Planet Rock. My guest is the returning Myles Kennedy. Myles, welcome back.
It's great to be here. Thanks for having me.
Always a pleasure. Well, the world has certainly changed somewhat since we last caught up.
It's changed a lot. Yeah. I mean, last time we saw each other, could you imagine? What if someone had said that all this was going to happen? We'd be like, come on.
Yeah, I know. I know. You know, it's in many ways, it only seems like a few weeks since I was standing in a field watching you do your version of I Maze the Trooper at Rambly Man Fair. And that, you know, fast forward a couple of seasons of life, and it's like, wow, everything changed. I mean, since the Year of the Tiger album, there's been an Alter Bridge album, and was the last Slash one before or after Year of the Tiger? Help my timeline. They're around the same time, weren't they?
It was right after, yeah.
That's right. And so you've literally morphed one project into the other. The new album, The Ides of March, which confuses me because out in May. I was going to say The Ides of May.
We weren't thinking on that front.
Was that the plan for now, or has the pandemic sort of changed the dynamic of when that album was coming? Has it changed anything, or was that always kind of in the can, ready to go?
Yeah, I mean, the schedule is pretty tight with all three things. So the plan was to get in the studio by August or so and make a record. What I didn't realize was that I was going to have a full, you know, 6 months or whatever it was to make a record, to write a record. I was actually concerned because we were in the thick of it doing the Alter Bridge Walk the Sky tour. And I remember telling my manager, I'm like, I don't know when I'm going to find a time to write this next solo record. And then about 2 weeks later, the world shuts down. And so I just thought, okay, not knowing how long it was going to last, that's part of the reason I went to work immediately in March and just started writing constantly and thinking the world maybe open up again in April or May. And then it just kept going on, and I just was able to accumulate more material and songs. So yeah, it's pretty crazy.
So when that album, when you finished doing that tour, did you miss the solo? Because I know you map everything out in advance, so you kind of know there's Alter Bridge, there's Slash, there's solo. Mm-hmm. Do you almost have a bit of a musical hangover, or do you instantly get motivated because you think, okay, cool, I've done that, I'm on to Alter Bridge? Or do you think, oh man, I'm really missing going out and playing on my own?
No, I find it with each thing, it's interesting. I wrap up and then it's kind of like the palate is cleansed and I'm ready to move on to the next thing. And I feel like it helps the other projects because you get to express yourself in one realm and you get that off your chest, and then you get to go and put on a different hat. So it's always keeping it fresh. You know, yeah. It's always keeping it. There's always like this new circumstance to keep your
gray matter going. Keep the brain.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. Keeps the gray matter going.
Yeah. So
the gray hairs are coming.
There's only about 4 or 5 years between us, and I know exactly what you mean. I'm getting them under there. That's why I'm wearing headphones. It covers them up.
Oh well, it looks it's distinct. It makes you look distinct.
Silver fox. That's
silver fox.
So essentially, you're more motivated than burnt out.
Yeah. If it's a really long 2019 was different. I'll be completely candid. That was 300 days plus on the road or in the studio away from home, and that one got me pretty. I was pretty fried. So it's interesting when everything shut down last year, and we you know couldn't tour, couldn't do anything. It was almost, the timing was actually not terrible for me because I was pretty tough.
It always fascinates me. Any musician who is in multi bands or even has multi roles in multi bands, how you differentiate between everything. So, for example, when you finished the Alter Bridge run in 2019 and you're doing your thing, do you want to keep everything separate to the point you're almost closed in, or do you want to say to Slash, what do you think of this during the writing process, or go to Mark Tremonti and say, what do you, or do you like just want to keep them out of it because it's a completely separate entity to them?
They're very different process. They're very different ways of songwriting, because with Slash, generally he'll present the music and then I come up with the lyric and the melody over the top of that. Occasionally I'll be like, hey, what do you think of taking this section here, and I've got a section, let's try this for a chorus for just to help with the melody. And generally it's that it's not me going, hey, I've got this music, let's use this, because he's a riff master, why would I
yeah,
right? So, and with Mark, we come together with parts of songs sometimes. Hey, do you have a verse that'll fit with my chorus, or vice versa? So it's a very different process. With the solo realm, I'm left to my own devices. I'm going to write the whole song. I'm going to demo the whole song, and it is what it is.
In 2021, you survived the great Guns N' Roses reunion. They got back together. It didn't change a damn thing for you. Creed didn't come back and whisk the rest of the band away, because I know we talked about that a few years ago, and you were saying that there were times you were thinking, well, what if Guns N' Roses do get back together? What if Creed do another reunion and they decide to have another run of it? You've seen them all off. You are one of the great...
Thing. The way I look at it is, if I'm just going to put an ad in the back of paper of the paper, and it's going to be like, do you want your band to get back together? Get Myles to sing with you.
Yeah, he will put the fear and insecurity into all those semi-retired musicians. So have you dared to plan? I mean, it's almost a scary word at this point in life. And I know that whenever there's a cycle of any album or a tour, there's usually a plan in place, anything from 6 to 18 months in advance. But it's like the UK's doing all right, and our roadmap to surviving and getting out and about and gigs again is okay. But, you know, various parts of the States, not so good. Canada's not looking great. Various parts of Europe, you're sort of sitting there thinking, you know what, I might write another album.
That's a good idea. Why not?
Yeah,
I mean, I probably should start thinking about that. I mean, we're trying to figure out how I'm going to tour the solo stuff. We'll see. You know, maybe it'll just be acoustic guitars and social distance settings. We'll keep our fingers crossed. You know, because I would love to tour this. You know, I put so much time into it. I would really like to take these songs out on the road. You know, if not, I'll just keep writing for everything else and see what happens.
Listen, I've really enjoyed listening to what I've heard of the album so far. I love the new single In Stride, because, you know, I'm hooked at slide guitar. So
thanks, man. Appreciate it.
I hope I'll see you in the UK, and we can stand in a field, usually a port cabin. We can put the world to rights. We can talk about the weather. We can talk about sport, or we can just talk about anything, you know.
That'd be great.
I
always love talking with you, man. So it's great to see. And yeah, hopefully we'll be able to do it soon.
Planet Rock.